Ladies and gentlemen, this has certainly been a season for experiment in the theater. The four-poster got the number of actors down to two. Emlyn Williams cut that in half. Cornelia Otis Skinner held the whole thing at par. I have only to leave this stage in order to break fresh ground. Even the production of Don Juan and Hell seemed to share in this passion for condensation. And so, building on the foundation they have laid, or rather removing what they have neglected to eliminate, we bring you what we consider to be the irreducible minimum. One obscure member of Actors' Equity reading a review. I shall now read new faces. First, the inevitable opening chorus. You've never seen us before. We've never seen you before. What a pleasant place to finally meet. Cast registers pleasure. So much pleasanter than a busy street. Cast does Times Square. We vocally take your hand and vocally shake your hand and ask you to regard this hullabaloo as I seem to have lost my place. How do you do, Mr. Orchestra? How do you do, Mrs. Mezzanine? How'd you do, Lord and Lady Balcony? You're the welcomest sight we've ever seen. We say it again, encore. You've never seen us before, but we hope before this evening ends, cast registers hope
that you'll be good friends.
Bonsoir, bonsoir. I'm sorry that I'm late, but I've been signing autographs since quarter after eight. Chérie, chérie, oh, je vous aime beaucoup. In case you don't speak French, that simply means that I love you, oh, l'amour encore. If I was tall, I'd love you more. But since I'm not, accept me as I am. And who can tell your mademoiselle, you may be my madame.
Call me madame.
Pardon me, monsieur, I'm from the Morning Star. It's evident that you're a man of fame. It's also very clear I should know who you are, but somehow I just can't recall your name.
What? You don't know who I am?
What? You don't know who he is?
No. Who is he?
Shall I tell him?
Yes.
I'm the man of the hour, I'm the man of the year. I'm the fellow who has not from here to here to here to here. I'm the meaning of debonair. Who am I? I'm Lucky Pierre.
Pierre!
I'm the man of the century, the man of the age. Why, my name will be in history on every single page. I'm the man who is always there. Who am I? I'm Lucky Pierre.
Pierre!
I'm the boy, may we wee. What a joy to be me. If you think that I brag and if you think that I boast, just be quiet and you'll hear them shout my name from coast to coast. And the echo resounds in the air.
Yeah.
Laissez faire for Lucky Pierre.
Yeah.
Though he's not very handsome and he's not very strong, in a cabin in a blizzard, he's the one you bring along. He's the kick in a maiden's prayer. Who is he? He's Lucky Pierre.
From the banks of the Hudson to the banks of the Nile, just repeat my name and voila, you'll be serviced with a smile. From Trafalgar to Herald Square, none compare with Lucky Pierre.
Busy
bee,
lucky flower.
I'm the man of the hour, I'm the man of the year, I'm the man that every living husband has the right to fear. He may hide his madame in Seville or Siam, where she is, there I am. Vive la chère, chez la femme, c'est la vie, mes amis, c'est la guerre.
His movements, he writes me off as property improvements. He takes me off his income.
Stop.
Now. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Abigail Brown, bachelor stenographer, was late for work today for the first time in 20 years. She refused to talk about it, but the following memo was found on her desk. In shorthand. Tropical nights, orchids in bloom, sultry perfume, intrigues and dangers with passionate strangers. I've seen it all. I met him in Boston, in the native quarter. He was from Harvard, just across the border. It was a magical night, with romance everywhere. There was something in the air, there always is in Boston. We went to the Casbah, that's an Irish bar there, the underground hideout of the D.A.R. there. Something inside of me said, watch your heart, mademoiselle, and it might be just as well to watch your purse in Boston. We danced in a trance, and I dreamed of romance, till the strings of my heart seemed to be knotted, and even the palms seemed to be parted. The Boston Begin was casting its and cheap muscatel. We went to the Common, that's a pretty park there. As I remember, it was pretty dark there. In this exotic locale, by a silver lagoon, underneath we fell asleep in Boston. That was the story of my one romance there. Our dream of adventure didn't stand a chance there. How could we hope to enjoy all the pleasures ahead when the book we should have read were all suppressed in Boston, exotic Boston, land of the free, home of the brave, home of the Red Sox, home of the Bean, and home
about love, they complicate it so.
Love, c'est la vie en rose.
Love, justice, I know. Love is a simple thing. Love is a silver ring, shiny as a ribbon bow, soft as a quiet snow. Love is a nursery rhyme, old as the tick of time. Love is so many things, bright as an angel's wings, gentle as the morning light, long as a winter night. Love makes an old heart sing, and it fills every empty space. Love is a warming place. Love is a un bouquet de roses, brillant comme un beau diamant, comme de la neige qui tombe doucement. Love, c'est un d'enfant, vieux comme le tic-tac-tic-tac du temps. Love, c'est un million de franges blancs comme des ailes d'ange, comme une nuit de mai, fait pour des gens de paix. Chanter le vieux cœur, bannis tous les gens moqueurs. Love, c'est un coin charmant. Love nous rend tous contents. Love is a simple thing. Love is a silver ring, more fun than a puppet show, bright as a scarlet bow. Love is the thunder and rain. Is a pink balloon, sad as an old buffoon, wild as a storm at sea. Love is sheer insanity. Love is a touch of spring, and it gives you a sudden grace. Love is a special face. Love is a simple thing.
Comme un beau diamant, comme la neige qui tombe doucement.
Love makes an old heart sing,
and it gives you a sudden grace. Love is a special place. Love is a simple thing.
And now, love is seen through the eyes of a Charles Adams character.
Love is a simple thing. Love is a poison ring, shiny as a lizard's tongue, quiet as a man who's hung. Love is so great and grand, soft as a mummy's hand. Love is the raven's croak, sweet as the poison oak, brighter than a coffin nail, gay as a widow's wail. Love makes an old heart stop. Love is the mating call, when you've sealed him in the wall. Love is a simple thing.
buys me anything I please. We have a limited partnership with limitless possibilities. He takes me off his income.
Stop!
Really? Ladies and gentlemen, the next scene takes place in the Scottish Highlands in the wee Dachan Doris on the old Loch Lomond, where there lived a lassie named Nanty. Today is her 17th birthday. The cast includes her father, her mother, her boyfriend, and her brat of a brother, and all of them in kilts. At the moment, Nanty is letting doon her skirt and putting up her hair. Well, really.
Och, today is Nanty's birthday. Today she's 17. The sweetest, solemnest birthday our Nanty's ever seen. But she's feeling shy, and I'll tell you why, as she gazes up the stair. For today she's letting down her skirt and putting up her hair.
Oh, Nanty, my Nanty, it gives me heart to pain to think my lass will be grown up when she comes down again. When she was wee, ah, dearie me, she'd follow me everywhere. And now she's letting down her skirt and putting up her hair.
Our Nanty's now a lady, nay, mare, she is a maid.
I cannot forget the bairn she was in the games we played. I mind the moon that she was born,
and now she's standing there
on the brink of letting down her skirt and putting up her hair.
I've counted all the candles, there isn't a name mistake. I never set eyes in all me life on sick of delightful cake. But Nanty, oh, you are so slow, I dinna believe you dare. You winna be letting down your skirt and putting up your hair.
Och, dinna you taunt your sister laddie, and dinna you jibe her jeer.
The poor wee lass is bashful, she might feel kinda queer.
And dinna you clack when she comes back,
and dinna you smirk no stare.
Just because she's letting down her skirt and putting up her hair. Let none of us take notice when Doon or Nanty comes, but gaze up at the ceiling, a twiddling of our thumbs,
as though it were an ordinary, everyday affair.
For a lass to be letting Doon her skirt and putting up her hair. We'll whistle a tune, we'll whistle a tune when Doon she comes at best.
I didn't see how you'd be whistling a tune, you'd be laughing fit to burst.
Ach, leave the cake, for goodness sake, I didn't see how you dare. When a lassie is letting doon her skirt and putting up her hair.
She's coming anew, she's coming anew.
She couldn't have been so quick.
She's coming anew.
Ach, hold your tongue, or I'll give you a lick of the stick.
She's coming anew.
Wished it's true.
She's creeping along the stair.
Well, to be letting doon her skirt and putting up her hair.
From the office,
Did you miss your train? Were you caught in the rain? No, don't bother to explain. Can I fix you a quick martini? As a matter of fact, I'll have one with you. For to tell you the truth, I've had quite a day too. Guess who I saw today, my dear? I went in town to buy the kids a thing or two, and thought I'd stop to have a bite when I was through. I looked around for some place near, and it occurred to me where I had parked the car. I'd seen a most attractive French cafe and bar. It really wasn't very far. The waiter showed me to a dark, secluded corner, and when my eyes became accustomed to the gloom, I saw two people at the bar who were so much in love that even I could spot it clear across the room. Guess who I saw today, my dear? I've never been so shocked before. I headed blindly for the door. They didn't see me passing through. Guess who I saw today? I saw you.
You know, in France, we usually celebrate our 4th of July by having what you call a block dance. We dress ourselves as American jitterbugs and cowboys.
C'était le soir de 14 juillet.
She says it was the 14th of July.
Quelques lampions qui tremblaient sur un fil.
The streets were all decorated with lanterns.
Faisait briller solitaire et discret.
She meets a boy.
Un petit bal au milieu de la ville.
Et naturellement, they fall in love.
Bal, petit bal, où j'étais qu'une nuit, souviens-toi, tu n'étais pour moi ce soir-là, rien qu'une inconnue. Bleu, au bien vert, tes yeux lumineux, sans si clair, ils m'ont mis la tête à l'envers, sur un air de fête. Je me souviens, tout patron, sympathique, qui discutait politique avec l'agent phlegmatique. Pour nous deux, un seul musicien paresseux et avant léger qui faisait voler tes cheveux. Et quand le dernier lampion s'est éteint, un grand amoureux tenait dans la ville. C'est de le nôtre dansant au matin. Un petit bal devenu tranquille. Bal, petit bal, where I first met you. There you stood under a lantern alone. Blue, green, your bright shining eyes made my head turn upside down. Remember the man who tried to talk politics? We scarcely heard him. For us, there was a lone violinist. It's a night I'll always remember. Ah, mes amis, ce fut une belle noce. Le patron et ce oui gosse étaient venus en carrosse. Oui. Maintenant, nous voilà clients pour longtemps de ce petit bal pour amour un soir ensemble. Nous a réunis pour toute la vie. Nous arrive pour toute la vie. Adieu.
I've been called names by many a bride. I admit they cause me pain. But lately I've been classified as a long-term capital gain. He takes me off his income tax. Well, oh dear. Ladies and gentlemen, every musical review contains material which is, to put it mildly, extraneous. In our case, we had to drop three musical numbers while on the road because we thought them too similar to those in other reviews and not as good. Unfortunately, the composer had a rider in his contract which specified that these numbers must be given one performance in New York and on a night of his own choosing. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is the night. With great reluctance, we present for the first and definitely the last time a tragic ballad, a Venetian barcarolle, and a masquerade finale. Here they are, Three for the Road, or The Last Rider.
It's raining memories. I don't need a weatherman to tell me that. It's raining memories. And it's also raining rain. Just look at my hat. It's rained the day that I found you, waiting for a crushed-down bus. It rained the night that I lost you. The gods were playing house and fire with us. It's raining memories. Memories of days when you and I were one. It's raining memories. And it's also raining like a son of a gun. Romance is just an empty fizzle. In its grip, I'm a drip in a dreary drizzle. Raining memories on me.
Waltzing in Venice with you isn't so easy to do. If you should take one more step than you ought to, you will be doing the waltz underwater. Oh, what joy could ever compare with waltzing in Venice with care?
What a thrill when the waltz is a fast one, knowing each step it will be your last one. Oh, fatiguing the Venice, intriguing with Venice, it's waltzing in Venice with you.
Take off the mask, please take off the mask. I know you, I'd know you anywhere. So I ask you, take off the mask you wear. Please be fair, won't you lose your aplomb? Take off the domin. Oh, you're hiding behind. It's no secret to me that you'll turn out to be my ideal. For I feel that I've known ya in Estonia, and I want to bat for ya down in Latvia. All the things I've been to ya in India, I haven't forgotten. So please don't be rotten and take off the mask. That's all that I ask you to do. Please take off your false face and just let me waltz face to face with you.
No, 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 you naughty boy. Though you may think me haughty boy, I must refuse what you're asking me. You must not think of unmasking me before 12 o'clock. That is how the game is played. Ooh, at the masquerade.
Yes, 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 you saucy miss.
No.
I will be bold and bossy miss. Till midnight I don't choose to wait.
What?
Matter of fact, I refuse to wait. So take off your mask. That's just what I'm going to do. Put back the mask, that's all that I ask you to do.
Take off the mask, that's all that I ask you to do. Please take off the false face and just let me false face and face with you. What a thrill when the waltz is a fast one, knowing each step may well be your last one. All the jigging, the tennis, intriguing, the madness is waltzing in Venice with you. In Venice,
life has been kind to me. I've riches enough to buy whatever catches my eye, but nothing catches my eye. My appetite has faded. Alas, the lady's jaded. When I was a little girl, poor and plain, all I asked of life was in this refrain. Penny, candy, candy for a penny. I wish I could still get a kick from a penny peppermint stick or an indigestible gummy hat that stuck to my teeth and made me fat. Penny, candy, candy for a penny. I wish I could bounce a red ball on the brick of a tenement wall and never ask for more at all, at all. The candy store I could never pass without pressing my nose against the glass. Candy, candy, and oh how I'd sigh, alack, alack, for a doll made of sweet chewing wax. Penny, candy, candy for a penny. I ask for more than a penny now. I've grown very wise, you see, but I wish that a sweet were still fun to eat. Now a penny's a memory.
Penny, penny, penny for a penny.
Hey, mister, can we please have a moxie with four straws? Two for my friend Gussie and two for me. Stop blowing bubbles, Gussie. All I'm getting is foam. Hey, we got 2 cents left. Should we get a jawbreaker or a licorice stick? Hey, mister, can we just please have a jawbreaker? No, not the white one. We like pink. No, not that one on top. That one way down there on the bottom. Oh, thanks, mister. You know what I'm gonna be when I grow up? A movie star like Vilma Bankey. Mama told me what you're gonna be. An elephant. Geez, I didn't mean to hurt your feelings, Gussie. Maybe when you grow up, you'll get skinny like a snake. Don't cry, Gussie. It's your turn for the jawbreaker. If you stop crying, you can keep it.
Penny, candy, candy for penny.
I ask for more than a penny now. I've grown very wise, you see. But I wish that a sweet were still fun to eat. Now a penny's a memory.
This is the 5th anniversary of the day when we were wed. 3 o'clock, all is well in the nursery, and my husband is dozing on the bed. We had a little celebration when you celebrate the glasses clink, and the object of my adoration had a little bit too much to drink. Oh, my tight one, can you hear? Oh, my right one, oh, my dear. Fall asleep, not right away. want to be said. Don't fall asleep, sleepyhead. Open your eyes, lend me your ears. Darling, listen to this lady who cheers. Cheers for the years we're celebrating today. Hip hip hooray for today. Counting all the days that have passed. Days pass so fast. Days when we wondered if we'd ever last. I'm very glad, very happy to add that today's the finest day we've had. So don't fall asleep, don't fall asleep. Here's a secret that can no longer keep. I'm more than thankful to be able to say on this loveliest day of my life that this lady who's saying don't fall asleep is you.
A mistress and a yacht. Now he's left with just a wife and an old canoe. He takes me off his income tax. Oh, well. Ladies and gentlemen, this next scene really needs no introduction. Therefore, I shan't make any.
What's the matter with me? What's the matter with me? School is let out and it's way after three. But I'm sitting here with my chin on my knee. Say, what is the matter with me? I should be at home and I wanna go home. But I know darn well I'm not gonna go home. So I just sit here with my chin on my knee. What the heck is the matter with me? What if the gang saw me sitting like this? They think I was waiting for some girl. So what if they saw me? They couldn't hee-haw me, 'cause I'm not waiting for any girl. Then what am I waiting here for? And why am I watching the door? I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love with Miss Logan. I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love with Miss Logan. Though I still hate arithmetic, I'll pass arithmetic, long as Miss Logan is teaching arithmetic. I'm in love with Miss Logan, and I wish I was not. I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, that's my slogan. With an angel who flies up above, that's Miss Logan. Though the study of history still is a mystery, she teaches history, I learn my history. I'm in love with Miss Logan, and I hope nobody finds out.
Oh, hello, Andre.
Hello, Miss Logan.
Are you waiting for someone?
No, mademoiselle.
Everybody's gone home. I'm the last one.
I know, ma'am.
Did you want to see me?
Oh, no, ma'am.
Andre, is there anything wrong?
No, ma'am.
Are you sure?
Hmm? Yes, ma'am.
All right, then. Coming, Andre?
No, ma'am.
Andre, you sure
isn't... Hello, Mary.
Hello, darling.
Sorry I'm late.
Please, darling, not in front of the little boy.
Why not?
Good night, Andre. See you tomorrow. He's a funny little fella. Sweet, though.
If there's one person that I don't love, it's Miss Logan. If there's one person I'd like to shove, it's Miss Logan. She could talk to me, sing to me, candy bars bring to me, hold me and cling to me, don't mean nothing to me. I don't love old Miss Logan, and I wish I was dead.
Everyone gets into a dull routine if they don't get a chance to change the scene. I could not be wearier, life could not be drearier, if I lived in Siberia. I'll tell ya what I mean. I met a rather amusing fool while on my way to Istanbul. He bought me the Black Sea for my swimming pool. Monotonous for 30 days. Salt air I sniffed while I was shipwrecked and cast adrift with a man who looked like Montgomery Clift. Monotonous for what it's worth throughout the earth. I'm known as Femme Fatale, but when the yawn comes up like thunder, brother, take back your Taj Mahal. Jack Fath made a new style for me. I even made Johnny Ray smile for me. A camel once walked a mile for me. Monotonous. I could not be wearier, life could not be drearier, if I lived in Siberia. Traffic has been known to stop for me, prices even rise and drop for me, Harry S. Truman plays bop for me. Monotonous. Monotonous. T.S. Eliot writes books for me. King Farouk's on tender hooks for me. Sherman Billingsley even cooks for me. Monotonous. Monotonous. I could not be wearier, life could not be drearier, if I lived in Siberia. Although I know I've acres of dough, I'm not sure of the amount. It might be exciting someday. Check sends me pots of tea. Gaylord Houser sends me vitamin D. And furthermore, Ike likes me. Monotonous. Monotonous. Monotonous.
We were too rich, too beautiful for true love. That's what Papa and Mama said.
I wonder if they were right. Mama is gone.
Papa too.
Leaving two little girls with nothing to do.
Time for tea, time for tea. Lavinia, come to tea. Dusty, 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 dusty teapot. You're as old as I. Can anyone be as old as I? They can if they try. They can if they try to be as old as I.
just lived too long with a memory in an empty house, and me,
you'll soon be as old as, soon be as old as, soon be as old as me.
As I, you'll soon be as old as we. Poor old house, aren't you weary of us? We'll never leave you, never go out the door. What for? House, you were young then like us. And oh, what beauties we were, we three, the house and thee and me.
Here, kitty, 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 kitty. Tomorrow we must blow the dust away, take the covers away. Tomorrow is our debut. John Chester is coming. He wrote me a note. He'd be here. I'm saving the waltzes for John. Come, kitty, we must blow the dust away.
Remember our debut in 1902.
I was 18 in 1902. My gown was made in France by Patou for the dance.
Mine was from Pequin with pale pink satin bow and silver bells and cockle shells and pretty old maids in a row. The musicians played encore. I fairly flew round the ballroom floor, but I failed to fall in love that night. Though the men were handsome and my head was lit,
me with a smile, and we waltzed and we waltzed, then we stopped for a while to dream. John was the man for my heart, though we'd only met to part. For Papa appeared with a righteous glare. He saw us kissing behind the stair, and his eyes were as cold as the sea. His eyes were as cold as the sea. That was the last I saw of John, and the last John saw of me.
Remember our debut in 1902.
Kitty, 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 kitty. We were too rich, too beautiful for true love. That's what Papa and Mama said. I wonder if they were right.
Time for tea, time for tea. You'll soon be as old as, soon be as old as, soon be as old as me.
As I, you'll soon be as old as we. Yeah, kitty, 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 kitty.
I just got in from Salem and I'd like to get the facts. Someone named Lizzie Borden has done something with an axe, and you're worried because the hoedown usually held on Saturday night might be ruined because of Lizzie. Is that your problem?
Right! What in the world's gonna happen to the hoedown now?
something wrong with the hoedown.
What in the world's gonna happen to the hoedown now?
What went wrong with the hoedown?
What in the world's gonna happen to the hoedown since Elizabeth back did lowdown? What in the world's gonna happen to the hoedown now?
Who's Elizabeth?
How in the world are we ever gonna have it now?
Lizzie Borden.
How in the world are we ever gonna have it now?
Shake hands with the warden.
How in the world are we gonna have a hoedown? It's a day for business showdown. How in the world are we ever gonna have it now?
What happened?
Don't you know?
The thing that happened without any warning.
The biggest news since Mrs. Hughes went up a not balloon.
Oh!
What in the world's gonna happen to the hoedown now?
You mean the trial of Lizzie?
What in the world's gonna happen to the hoedown now?
It's gonna keep you busy.
What in the world's gonna happen to the hoedown? Will we let the hoedown go down? What in the world's gonna happen since she caught her parents napping? What in the world's gonna happen to the Saturday afternoon? Oh!
Now, as I see it, Lizzie Borden is slightly out of step. Because she made them put off the hoedowns, that's the problem?
Yep!
That means the regular social function can't be held because of the trial.
Of course we could get out and jump.
Or else we could.
Wait a while. Go tell Mrs. Elmer Drury to come down here and set on the jury. Go get Ebenezer Burney.
Who is he?
District Attorney.
And tell Mrs. Jones to leave her fudge and go into the bedroom to wake up the judge. Get Miss Lizzie to bring that axe and come on down with a couple of facts. I got a plan that'll make you smile. We'll have the hoedown with the trial. Come on, everybody.
We'll have the hoedown with the trial.
Howdy, Lizzie.
Howdy, Judge.
Where's Mr. Burney?
District Attorney. There he is, Judge. There he is, Judge.
Order in the court. Lizzie, don't budge.
Yesterday in Old Fall River, Mr. Andrew Borden died. Now we got his daughter Lizzie on a charge of homicide. Some folks say she didn't do it. Others say, of course, she did. But we all agree Miss Lizzie B is a problem kind of kid. Cause you can't chop your papa up in Massachusetts. Not even if it's planned as a surprise. No, you can't chop your papa up in Massachusetts. You know how neighbors love to criticize. Now she got him on the sofa where he'd gone to take a snooze. And I hope he went to heaven cause he wasn't wearing shoes. She sort of rearranged him with a hatchet, so they say. And then she got her mama in that same old-fashioned way.
Why you can't chop your mama up in Massachusetts?
Not even if you're tired of her cuisine. Oh, no!
No, you can't chop your mama up in Massachusetts.
You know, it's almost sure to cause a scene. Yes, they really kept her hopping on that busy afternoon with down and upstairs chopping while she hummed a ragtime tune. They really made her hustle, and when all was said and done, she'd removed her mother's bustle when she wasn't wearing one.
But you can't chop your mama up in Massachusetts.
And then blame all the damage on the mice. Oh, no.
No, you can't chop your mama up in Massachusetts.
That kind of thing just isn't very nice. Now, it wasn't done for pleasure, and it wasn't done for spite, and it wasn't done because the lady wasn't very bright. She always did the slightest thing her mom and papa bid. They said, Lizzie, cut it out, and that's exactly what she did.
But you can't chop your mama up in Massachusetts.
Then get dressed and go out for a walk.
No, you can't chop your mama up in Massachusetts.
Massachusetts is a far cry from New York.
Well, what do we do now?
Let's have a hoedown.
What do we do about her?
About me?
About you?
What do we do?
Say, what are we waiting for?
Did you do it, Liz?
Yeah, me, no.
Is that good enough for you, Judge?
I guess so.
Is that good enough for you, folks?
Yes.
Then, Lizzie, you're free.
Me.
Now let the hoedown progress.
Shut the door and lock and latch it. Here comes Lizzie with a brand new hatchet.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Cross your fingers, knock on wood. Local girl is making good. Such a snob, I've heard it said. She met her pa and cut him dead.
You can't jump your mama up in Massachusetts.
Jump like a fish, jump like a porpoise. I'll take hands in habeas corpus.
You can't jump your mama up in Massachusetts.
Massachusetts is a far cry from New York.
What is he born?